Hello everyone, Harry here. Welcome to Scrap Science. I'm making this video today because I need some methyl ethyl ketone, or butanone if you would prefer, for a future video. Now, methyl ethyl ketone is a somewhat obscure solvent. It's obscure enough that it's not really a commonly sold item in most hardware stores. I had a look around my local hardware stores and none of them sold it directly. So having a bit more of a search around, I was able to find PVC priming fluid, which apparently, according to the label, contains, get that into focus, 60 to 100% methyl ethyl ketone. Now, for the purposes that I need methyl ethyl ketone for, I don't need it to be particularly pure. I can definitely handle a bit of water contamination and like maybe a few other hydrocarbons, but 60% is pretty bad if it's that low. And I would like to do my best to purify the methyl ethyl ketone that's in it to the best of my ability. And really the only way that we can kind of try to do that is by distillation. You've probably noticed the distillation setup that I've got ready here. So yes, we're going to distill our methyl ethyl ketone. Of course, if we wanted to really purify it, fractional distillation would be best. But as I said earlier on, I really don't need a super high purity. And if a few other similar volatility solvents come over with it, that's really no big deal. All I really want to do is get rid of any super volatile components that are in this product. And I'd also like to get rid of any super low volatility components that are often present in products that you use with PVC. Anyway, super simple video, hopefully. It should be a pretty straightforward distillation because the boiling point of methyl ethyl ketone is around 80 degrees Celsius. It may form an azeotrope with water if our product has a bit of water contamination in it, but that's fine too because I don't mind a bit of water in my methyl ethyl ketone. And of course, I'm making this video and uploading it because if there's anyone else out there who needs some methyl ethyl ketone and lives in a place where they don't sell it directly as a solvent, this will be a little demonstration of where you can get it from. First things first, of course, we need to put our methyl ethyl ketone into the boiling flask. Of course, the container comes with this application brush, which is a little bit annoying, but we'll cope. Right, just pouring it straight in. And that's ready to go. Now I'm going to have to do this in three runs, of course, because the size of my current distillation setup only allows for the distillation of around 250 milliliters of solvent at a time. So seeing as we have three 250 milliliter containers of the solvent, we are going to need to do this three times. Regardless, as I said earlier, this should be a pretty straightforward distillation. I'm just gonna heat this up, possibly just discard anything that boils over before 70 degrees, and then anything that boils above that, between 70 degrees and maybe 90 degrees, should be mostly methyl ethyl ketone. So we will wait for the boiling flask to heat up and then watch the distillation progress. Before we start distilling, it might be important to note that the solvent is actually extremely clear. I mean, you can barely see it in there. So it's possible that the purity of the methyl ethyl ketone in the original product is actually close to 100%, which would be kind of interesting, make the whole distillation pointless, but we've got to do it to find out, I suppose. Couple of minutes in, just starting to boil now. We'll see what temperature this first stuff comes across at. All right, apparently very few volatile components. This stuff came across in about 10 seconds and then the temperature shot up to around 75 degrees, which is about where we expect the azeotrope of methyl ethyl ketone and water to be. Quite honestly, this is about the fastest distillation I've ever seen. You can see a whole bunch of solvent collecting in the receiving flask right now, and all of that is collecting between 75 and 80 degrees Celsius. Thank you. About 15 minutes into the distillation, we have distilled a little over 2/3 of all of the solvent. I think I said before, but this is about the quickest distillation I've ever done. At this point, we're seeing the temperature climb to nearly 90 degrees, which is a little bit above the boiling point of methyl ethyl ketone by itself. The azeotrope, of course, with water is actually a bit lower. That's around 75 degrees. Anyway, I'm thinking that the very last bit of solvent we might not collect, simply because that's going to contain all of the high boiling components. All right, disaster strikes a little bit. Sadly, coming to the end of our distillation here, the heating mantle has completely stopped working. I knew this was going to happen at some point soon because the element has actually broken in the past, and I've had to go in there and reconnect things multiple times now, and I think this is about the point where I'm just going to say I'm done with this heating mantle. I have ordered another one, but it's not here yet. Sadly though, that means that this distillation has been stopped short. Luckily though, the heating mantle stopped working at around the point where the still head temperature reached approximately 90 degrees, which was where I planned to cut off the distillation anyway. There's a small amount of solvent left inside our boiling flask, and most of our product is of course over here in our receiving flask. I am of course not going to be able to do the rest of the priming fluid to extract the methyl ethyl ketone from those, but I think we have achieved what we set out to do and purify some methyl ethyl ketone from the hardware store priming fluid. Once my new heating mantle comes, I will of course distill the rest of it, maybe off camera, but for the time being, I suppose this quantity of solvent is enough for me to work with. I'll be storing the butanone in one of these chemical bottles until I need to use it. So just pour that straight in. And that's ready to go. Here you can see the slightly higher boiling components of the original mixture. There's not much left here, and I definitely think it is still mostly methyl ethyl ketone because the boiling temperature never really got too far above the boiling point of methyl ethyl ketone. Regardless, for the sake of purity and simply because this stuff is actually extremely cheap from the hardware store, I'm going to be saving this and discarding this, or at least I'll be putting it back into its original container and possibly using it directly as priming fluid anyway. I won't be doing chemistry with it, but it'll still find a use, I'm sure. And well, there you have it, the super simple extraction and possibly mild purification of methyl ethyl ketone from PVC priming fluid if you can't buy methyl ethyl ketone directly. It is pretty nice to have a short video work out for us like this, of course, bar the fact that our heating mantle broke, but I will get straight on to using this stuff for its intended purpose, and I will see you later.